And welcome back to my channel, Olively Natural. Those are just some products that I like to use in my hair. I obviously like to keep things short and simple because I'm not a product junkie like a lot of people. No offense to the product junkies out there, okay? So I'm just gonna explain to you guys like why I like to use those products. So yeah. All right, the first product that I'm gonna show you guys is the Cantu Shea Butter for Natural Hair. It is their coconut curling cream. My mom got me hooked on this stuff. Shout out to my mom, all right? This stuff really does everything that it says it'll do. It makes my hair feeling soft, shiny, and deeply moisturized. And my hair could get a little dry sometimes, so this stuff really does a job. It also contains no mineral oil, sulfates, parabens, and all that bad stuff that you do not want to put in your hair. I got it from Walmart, but you could also get it from Sally's or Target or any of those commercial stores that you like to shop at because it'll be there. And it's also not that expensive, less than 10 bucks. I think I pay like $5 or $6 for it. So if you want a good product that'll moisturize your hair and is for a good price, I highly recommend this stuff. Also, the consistency is very nice. It's not too thick, but it also is not too slippery. It just has that perfect creamy texture just to moisturize your hair and keep it from feeling really, really dry. So the next product that I'm gonna show you guys is this stuff. What is it? The best thing ever. My mommy made this for me. It basically contains shea butter and a ton of essential oils. Some of the essential oils include coconut oil, almond oil, jojoba, how do you pronounce that? Well, anyway, the consistency is very thick, but once you rub it together, it gets kind of creamy and it makes your hair feel so good and moisturized. I like to pair it with the Cantu Shea Butter Natural Cream thing. I feel like if you use those two together, you get the perfect breakout ever. If you would like to know how to make it, maybe I'll make a video in the future, especially since I'm going home for Thanksgiving next week. So leave a comment down below if you would like to know how to make this awesome stuff right here. Next up, we have Jamaican Black Castor Oil, man. Oh, that was so bad. Well, Jamaican Black Castor Oil is really good. It's very thick for those of you who don't know. It's great for regrowing your hair. Side note, I like to put it on my eyebrows to make my eyebrows grow, but that's not important in regards to my hair. This stuff is really, really, really good. I just read the back of this and it says you can make a hot oil treatment, so I might try this out later because that will do some really good stuff in my hair. It helps strengthen your hair, replenish, rejuvenate, nourish, and it contains all natural ingredients. So if you really want a good oil that'll help regrow your hair and prevent dandruff and just keep your hair moisturized, I highly recommend some Jamaican Black Castor Oil, man. Yes. I'm not doing that again. Next, the lovely liquid gold olive oil. I love olive oil. It's very thin. It's not as thick as castor oil. So I use olive oil a bit more frequently than I use castor oil. I use olive oil after I finish washing my hair, right before I put in my moisturizer and my hair's still a little damp. That way I can still work through my hair because as my hair dries and shrinks, there's no part in the Red Sea with that. Olive oil is great for sealing in moisture. I mean, honestly, you don't even really need like moisturizing products as long as you have some water and some essential oils such as olive oil, then you're good to go. But moving on to products that I like to use when I wash my hair and condition my hair. This is Shea Moisture's Raw Shea Butter Moisture Retention Shampoo. This stuff is so good. I think it's very important that you invest in a somewhat expensive shampoo because shampoo will strip your hair of all its natural moisture, and that's not good. You do not want to get a shampoo that has a lot of sulfates. You want to get a shampoo that's natural and moisturizes your hair and does not strip your hair of all its moisture. So I highly recommend Shea Moisture's shampoo because when I first used it, as opposed to using like some cheap Suave shampoo. No offense to Suave because I'm gonna get to Suave later. But in comparison to the swash shampoo that I was using at the time, once I used that Shea Moisture shampoo, man, my hair felt moisturized. Like, I was like, am I putting in conditioner or am I using a shampoo? So I highly recommend it. Remember when I said I was going to get to Suave later? Well, now it's later, and this is a Suave conditioner. Now, I know I said that you should probably go expensive when it comes to shampoos, but when it comes to conditioner, go and get you some dollar conditioner, as long as it doesn't contain like mineral oil or sulfates. I like Suave because it's cheap and it keeps my hair moisturized when I want a good conditioner that's low on the price. This one is the Tropical Coconut infused with coconut extract and vitamin E. You might have to go through like the whole bottle if you have thick hair like me, but that's why you want to get a cheap conditioner. Note to self: expensive shampoo, cheap conditioner that doesn't contain mineral oils and sulfates. And that's all the products that I like to use in my hair. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for subscribing to Olively Natural. Later.